Okay, Member Bauer, since Chair Barker isn't available, if you would kindly run the meeting, that would be awesome.
Okay, run the meeting. Okay, meeting started.
Alrighty, I can go ahead and read the announcement and we can keep moving. How's that sound?
Perfect, go for it.
Okay, perfect. This meeting is live stream and temporarily closed in-person public participation. The clerk's office is in the process of hosting hybrid public meetings that will provide board members and members of the public with the option to participate in the meeting either in person or remotely. Thank you for your patience and support. To make a verbal comment at today's meeting, dial 916-875-2501 to provide your contact information. When the chair opens public comment for a specific agenda item or off agenda matter, callers will be contacted by phone and transferred into the meeting to make their public comment. Written comments are always accepted. Please feel free to send your email comments to boardclerk@saccounty.net, and your comment will be routed to the board and filed in the record. And on that note, we can continue moving forward. Member Bauer, if you would like to lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance, we can do so.
All right. Okay. I pledge allegiance to the flag, to the United States of America,
and to the
Republic with which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Woohoo! I'm glad that when I was a kid, I would never remember it otherwise.
Okay. And then if at your discretion, I can go ahead and take roll if you like.
You bet. Go for it.
Okay. Perfect. Members Bauer.
Well, I'm here.
Member Embley. Crystal Harding Jenkins.
Present.
Member Semenenko. Member Yule.
Present.
And Member Barker. And we do have a quorum. And Member Barker has informed me that she's moved out of the area, which leaves us with six members currently. So we, in essence, we do have a quorum. So, but anyways, we'll the clerk's office will update you as needed soon. So if you'd like, at your discretion again, we can move forward to item number one.
Very good.
Okay. Item number one is Lund Construction Company headquarters rezone. It's located on the south side of Antelope Road, approximately 550 feet west of Roseville Road in the North Highlands community. And the request is for a general plan amendment to change the land use designation of approximately 3.2 acres of land from the transit-oriented development designation to intensive industrial. Community plan amendment and rezone to change the land use designation of approximately 2.4 acres of land from the industrial office park to light industrial.
All right, continue.
Thank you, Lydia. Good evening, CPAC members. This is Meredith Holsworth, and I am the project manager for the Lund Construction General Plan Amendment and Rezone Project. Just want to confirm you can hear me okay?
Yes, we can hear you perfectly clear. Thank you, Meredith.
Great, thank you. I just wanted to note this PowerPoint was submitted before the date was changed due to the Thanksgiving holiday. So please just ignore the reference to the November 23rd meeting date. And if you could go to the next slide, thank you. For any interested members of the public, project information is available on our website at planningdocuments.saccounty.net by searching for the control number PLNP 2021-00195. Next slide, please. The project site is located on the south side of Antelope Road, approximately 500 feet west of Roseville Road in the North Highlands community. The site is currently undeveloped and is zoned M1 and MP. The subject parcel is surrounded by other industrial zoning and AR1. Next slide. The request is for a general plan amendment to change the use designation of approximately 3.2 acres from the transit-oriented development designation to intensive industrial, as well as a community plan amendment and rezone to change the designation of 2.4 acres from MP, which is industrial office park, to M1, which is light industrial. Next slide. Here's the exhibit showing the two adjacent parcels making up the site. The general plan amendment and rezone would result in both parcels being designated M1 and intensive industrial. Next slide. There is no development included in this entitlement request. Parcel A is intended for the Lund Construction Headquarter Building, which was approved under a separate design review application, and Parcel B would serve the adjacent headquarters. A boundary line adjustment has been completed on the site, resulting in the lot configuration that's shown in the presented exhibit. The final hearing body for this item is the Board of Supervisors, and at the time of this meeting, no comments have been received by members of the public. And that does conclude my staff presentation. I'm available for any questions, and we do have the applicant.
Members, do you have a question? Members, do you have a question?
So what is the significance of changing it from its current designation to where it is now? I mean, personally, I don't see any problem with the build, but and it was designated for, what was it, some sort of transit. If you can explain that, the mainly from my understanding, between the transit and then the industrial office park, I'd greatly appreciate that. And this is Member Yule.
So I can kind of provide reasoning for, or sorry, more of an explanation of the difference if that's what you're looking for, but the applicant can explain the reasoning for wanting to make that change.
Both would be great. Thank you.
Okay. Essentially, the light industrial zone allows more, I guess, obviously light industrial type uses, a little bit more in the warehousing storage type use rather than an industrial office park, which I think is pretty self-explanatory. The transit-oriented development general plan designation is typically overlaid in transit corridors. It's not usually used in industrial type development. So it's really to get both of these parcels to be matching and to not have not only different designations, but as you could see in the zoning, one of the parcels is actually zoned half of each of one of those, both M1 and MP. So it would just kind of make the project site viable, I guess, to be used for one development. But I'll let the applicant kind of explain a little further if they have more to add on that.
Thank you, that was helpful.
Yes, I'd like to hear the reasoning.
Meredith, this is Ryan Hooper, and I'll be representing Lund Construction tonight. Let me know when you'd like me to commence with my presentation. I think we can answer all of these questions fairly easily.
This is Member Bauer. If we could get a idea of the ultimate purpose, the reasoning behind why this is being done or asked for.
Absolutely. Thank you, Vice Chair Bauer, for the time tonight to present this. My name is Ryan Hooper. I'm with the law offices of Gregory Thatch, and we represent the Lund Construction Company. Lund is looking to move their headquarters to this site, the site being comprised of both the existing parcel as well as the one that is the subject this evening. The parcel that has already been approved for the headquarter building is light industrial, and the site that we're talking about this evening is currently office park. And as Meredith mentioned, office park does not allow service and storage uses, and that is what we are seeking to do on this parcel, as it is intended to serve the headquarters. So on one parcel that we already have approved is the building, and then this will be a storage and service yard to serve that headquarters building. So that is the purpose. Under the current zoning, it's not permitted. Under the requested zoning, it would be. The requested zoning, as Meredith also indicated, would bring both parcels into parity. They would have the same general plan designation, community plan designation, and zoning. As you'll see, I think as you could see from one of the exhibits that staff showed, much of the area around here is light industrial anyway. It's very consistent with what is found in the surrounding properties. The TOD, to be honest with you, we don't know why this property had a TOD designation. We've not been able to find a satisfactory answer from the county either. It seems to be maybe a relic, something that was an idea long ago. This area is not planned for a transit stop, a station. It's highly industrial in nature. And so the requested entitlement changes to industrial are very much in keeping with all of the uses surrounding the property. Does that answer your question, Chair Bauer?
It totally makes sense. I live within walking distance of that area, and there's a bunch of, I think there's a storage area, there's auto body shops. Now we have a new post office over there. We don't have to go on Watt Avenue, so we're just down the street on Stationers. So I think that's the area you're talking about, and it totally
it
makes
is.
Sense.
Yeah. We think it's a good fit. We think it's in keeping with the other half of our property as well as the surrounding properties. We think it's a really good fit here.
Any other questions or comments? Hearing none, what's next, Lydia? Vote?
Okay. At this point, there are, just for the record, there are no public comments in queue. And yes, we can go ahead and someone can make a motion.
Do I hear a motion?
Not sure exactly how to phrase it. I was looking to see if there was a comment, but I move to accept the proposal by the Lund organization for the change in distinction, I guess.
Designation. Do I have a second?
My apologies. I was having trouble finding my mute. I second that. This is Member Yule.
Okay, all in favor, unmute.
Aye.
Okay. Aye. And then let me do a roll call vote really quickly.
There, there you go.
Member Bauer. Embley. Member Harding Jenkins.
Aye.
Member Simoninko. Member Yule.
Aye.
And the motion passes with Member Simoninko and Embley absent.
And I'm sorry, I did try to ask a question. It's not going to change my vote or anything like that, but if you wouldn't mind if I asked Mr. Thatch a question regarding the Lund Company. And it's more personal regarding community, but do they take any special role within the community and try to help the current community that they're within? Do they have any special projects or anything that they do community-wise?
Kevin, I don't know if you are on, but would you like to speak to that? I don't know that Mr. Lund is on the call at this time, but what I can say is that Lund is very much integrated into the Sacramento region and into the Sacramento County in particular. They're looking to locate their headquarters here, as we've discussed. I think that is a real commitment to the Sacramento area. It's a lot of jobs. And then, you know, as it says in the name, Lund Construction, they're very much integrated into building out our community in a variety of different types of construction projects. So I think to answer your question, they're very much involved in the community.
Yeah, I was actually kind of more focused on like the North Highlands community, you know, and working in ways with the community members and bringing up that community. But certainly feel free to pass that on to Mr. Lund that that we as the community, you know, would respect that greatly.
I would. Because obviously there are huge... happy to pass that along. And I think that, you know, I mean, most evident is what they're doing here with these acres and taking a long vacant piece of property and activating it and doing something to bring jobs and to bring activity to this area.
And certainly that's helpful. Yeah, but I think the, you know, the other community action certainly would be helpful too as well. And you know, of course, that doesn't affect my vote by any means, but, you know, and that's why we're here, because we love our community. But feel free to pass that on to Mr. Lund that, you know, if he wants to do anything grassroots, you know, that the community would greatly respect that. But thank you.
Be happy to do so. Thank you very much for the comment.
Sure.
Okay, at your discretion, Vice Chair Bauer, I can move forward to item number two.
Absolutely.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it. Bye-bye.
Okay. And item number two is the staff update.
This is Meredith Holsworth again, just reporting that there is no staff update tonight.
Thank you, Meredith. And item number three is council member comments.
I have no comment, Member Bauer.
Any other members?
This is Harding Jenkins. I'm wondering what's to happen with the open seat now that Member Barker, is no longer in the district lines. Is it up to the Board of Supervisors to find another individual or community member to serve in that position?
Yes, it would be. And Member Harding Jenkins, if you will bear with us, I will take this information back to the clerk of the board, and then we will follow up with you with the exact process and procedure.
If I could answer that, this is Florence Evans with the clerk's office. So what will happen is we will advertise that seat. There'll be an open and filing period, and they will take those applications into consideration.
Thank you so very much for the information and clarifying. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, Flo.
Problem.
And were there any other council member comments at this time? Okay, at your leave, I can move forward to item number four.
Yes, thank you.
Okay, item number four is the public comment section, and there are no public comments at this time. And that leads us to the adjournment at your leave.
Well, we'll call to adjourn.
Alrighty. Good night, everyone.
Thank you.
Good night.
Good night. Thank you.